Yeah.
Y'all getting that room? Alright. They will hit you on some venti.
Alright. Let me sneak over here.
No, you in the way of the camera.
Come here.
Fuck yeah. What is
it? Right behind you.
No, it wouldn't.
A little bit lower.
That's the wrong idea.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah. Him ready? Hi, I'm Brian Wire, presidency of the Gulf Coast Minority Chamber of Commerce, and we're here today to welcome new members to our chamber, styled by Slimflyy. And what we're going to do here is have Victoria say a few words, and I'll come back to you, and then we're going to count down from 3 to 0, cut the ribbon, and yell and scream about this place being open today, being a new business here in our community. Victoria?
All right. Well, each of you that have been invited here, I feel like you guys have helped me along my journey, whether you guys have encouraged me, help paint it. I mean, my family, I just have an amazing support system. I love you guys through and through. I couldn't have done it without you. And a special thanks to my parents. Every garment.
All right.
They created it.
They created you.
Yes. And every garment that has come through me, my mom has touched it.
Wow. All right.
So, I just want to thank her. But I just really appreciate you guys, and this is really a special moment for me, and I thank each and every one of you for taking time out of your day to come here.
All right.
The Gulf Coast Minority Chamber has been around for 5 years in October. We just help out small businesses, minority businesses, veteran businesses to help get going. Unlike other chambers, we really do focus on us helping out a network of people that have unique challenges that other businesses may not encounter. So we're here to help out. We're here to be part of the community. And we're so happy for Victoria here to open her business up. She's amazing, so busy. She's done more stuff in the last few months than I've seen people around the community do take years to do. So it's amazing what she's done. You put her mind behind it, you put faith behind it, and you get it done. And she is definitely that kind of person. So congratulations, Victoria. So here's some big scissors. Like these gold scissors for you? Huh? You can cut those too. What we're gonna do, count down 3 to 0.
Hang on.
We're gonna yell and scream. People happy of the day being the grand opening. So here we go. 3, 2, 1.
What you want to tell Vicky real quick?
What you mean? What
you want to say to her before she come out here real quick? What you want to say?
No, I got to say it in there. I got to
say it
in there.
To the camera. She going to see this later. Come on, say it real quick.
Oh, wait a minute.
What you got?
I would just like to say to my daughter, Victoria, I don't know what it is in life that I have done to be able to be blessed with such an awesome, beautiful child as you, and creative and talented. I just want to say how much I love you. You have sacrificed so much to be here today for this special occasion. I would like to thank each and every one for coming out to help us celebrate this day. Thank you.
Perfect time. Here we go.
She wanted a
the birthday dress done for her birthday. And we reached out to another designer, and the designer couldn't make the dress. She was booked. So I told her, I said, you know what? I can make this dress for you. And I ordered all the stuff. She was like, I trust you. I trust you. I ain't got no choice but to trust you. So I created that dress, and that was my first design, and nobody could tell that it was the first time that I had ever created something from somebody. So I really appreciate you for even trusting me to do that for you. I love you through and through.
You gonna do it,
And another special shout out to my poster child over here. That's my cousin Pooh / my headache. She want a dress made every week. Everything in that window is something I made for her. So even what she has on today, I made that for her. So Miss Popularity over there, she's the one that keeps the momentum going. When she posts something, it just goes crazy. So I just want to tell you, I appreciate you. I love you. And it has made us even closer as a family. And I just love you to death.
I love you more.
And so I'm going to open the floor up for people, if you want to get up and say something or give some encouraging words or just say how we met or what I've done for you. I'm going to open that up until 4:45, and then we'll continue on. Mama, where you at? Because I know you want to say something.
Miller wants to say something.
He ain't gonna say nothing but smile and show them gold teeth.
Smile.
Hey, all you gotta do is come say thank you for coming out. God bless you. Good night. Y'all, my dad is shy. If y'all even get to hear him talk, y'all are privileged. Because he don't say much.
But really, I am proud of Vicki. I really am Vicki. Oh, yes. She's doing wonderful. And I thank her just like she's my own. Mm-hmm. She's great, and I love her. Okay?
Thank you.
Anybody else?
That's one of my favorite nieces. We spent a lot of time together when we were smaller. But as she grew, we drifted apart because we had different personalities. We didn't figure that out until, you know. So, but I still love her, and I'm so proud of her. Yeah, she did a great job here. Yeah.
Are these affirmations?
Yes.
The devil got my back out.
Literally.
But I made it. And I'm so glad. Divine timing, because I think that I have to say something for you. You already know I've said it behind closed doors, but there was something so divine about seeing good people give what they deserve, right? We're living in a world right now where everything is sensationalized. Bad people. Oh, I don't want to say bad people, but anybody wins, they get eyes on them. But this woman is so divine. Your talent is so amazing, and you are so humble. You have taught me humility, a type of humility that I've never seen in my life. I'm like, girl, Pop, what are you doing? Let me take a video. Forget I'm putting on my page. Your talent has always shone through, and you just kind of like, your talent's so big, sis. You ain't even got a cover on it. When you walk, we walk the streets of New York and LA, this girl, I be putting on my best stuff. And I'm like, Mom, I'm here. They stop her. Excuse me, where you get those shoes? Excuse me. Her or me? You don't have to talk. And your talent is so big, when you speak a little bit, it jumps on somebody. You know, I don't even know what I can do. I don't even didn't know what I could do until I met you. And it wasn't anything that you said, it's just you being you. And like I said, we're living in a time where people can talk, they can speak. I can be a motivational speaker, which I am. I can say things, but there's another level of inspiration to somebody who has the gift and says nothing, that just does the work. Put the, all the details together so perfectly, girl, that's God. You understand? You don't even have to open your mouth. I love you. I'm so proud of you. I don't even have all the words. I hope this was enough, okay?
Yes, you did.
I love you so much. I'm so proud of you.
Do anybody else want to come up after that?
No.
No,
I would say
no.
I would say no. Look.
Now, I just wanted to take the time to recognize my friend. We've been friends since Jehovah Lutheran, which is like 4. I've seen Vicky flourish from a little girl into a grown woman. And it's an honor to be here with her to celebrate this moment. There's a lot of firsts going on in this room. I thank her for allowing me to have my bread here and celebrate this moment here with her. Vicky called me earlier in the week last week and was like, she was going through some things. And my encouragement to her was, God has already done it. You just walk. Just walk. I've been through a lot personally, and I love her because I've leaned on her for a lot of different things, and I'm grateful to share this moment with her. And as we say in Judaism, B'chaim, it's a celebration, and I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to see her flourish and walk in her truth. So I love you.
I don't know who this stuff is. Is one of y'all
stuff? Oh, y'all see why I'm so humble. I've been surrounded by all these praying people. I don't have to do
all this fire.
Yeah.
All this fire, yeah.
Well,
Victoria,
I call
them
my time.
Yeah.
I'm vicious. I met her when she was in high school. She used to come to me with all these fancy hairstyles and test me to the max, you know. She always had that twinkle of smile and personality that flourished. Whatever hairstyle it was her creativity. Even though I was doing the work for her, it fit her. And over the years, we kind of really, really close, and then finding out that our grandmothers were friends. And she became my sister. And as Rivka and Quill, she's solid, y'all. Really solid. Have you back. Thick and thin. Jeff, you know, he been around too. We don't want nothing else more. This ain't even it. You know, you feel already.
Amen.
You've been there.
Yes.
And I always tell her, you know, put God first and everything else will follow. Your gifts will make room for you. And I already have. Mm-hmm. You know, you think these won't let you go over there. You just wait. You can get that one.
Yes, yes.
And
we
I'm learning that.
Yes.
We're going to write them. Just come from a good family. You know? And I love you. You know how I feel about you? Them movies, as we say, Doja and Mama.
Right.
Blessings.
I told you.
baby, it's already written in stone. Just go ahead and do what you're supposed to do. Even when times get tough and you feel like you're missing something, speak it into existence. You're gonna manifest it. I send her stuff all the time. I've seen stuff like on just different little websites. Go apply, they looking for the stones. You can do this for your floor, just whatever, because I know she got the talent. When it came time for her to make my birthday dress, I was like, Vicky, I know what you're gonna do. I trust you. I know whatever you do, it's gonna be beautiful. Just do it. And it was amazing. Like, I felt like I was on top of the world that night. That dress was beautiful. I wanted to wear it tonight, but I never got it clean and it was white. So y'all know how it goes.
But, Vicky, this can be on the road. Thank you. I love you, and I'm so proud of you.
I'm so inspired and encouraged by you. Don't stop being.
I would just like to say to my daughter, I look at her every day and I thank God for allowing me to be the mom. She's such an awesome, wonderful daughter. She's always been there for me. And we're like Thelma and Louise. We're just like planning together while she's been down here on a daily basis. Our relationship is getting closer and closer. And I tell her all the time, I say, you don't let other people deter you. You put your feet forward because God got you. I say, I know he has a halo over you because when you was born, I took you and laid you back, took on the altar and gave you back to him. So I know he has her back. So I told her, just keep the faith and don't let nobody deter her and tell her what she can't do because I know what she can do. She's an awesome child. Always have been obedient, and I just love her to death. Thank y'all guys for coming out. Thanks.
She was very afraid of doing it, and I kept encouraging her to do so because she is a great young lady. She's like a daughter, and we've always talked about her doing it, not doing it. I used to always tell her, do it. You know, it's like when you're in a nest, you gotta fly from mama, it's okay. It's like, you know, when you get married, you leave the house. It's the same thing. And so she was wanting to do it. She showed us always at work, her work, very beautiful and very inspiring. And the way her friend said, you know, the way the world is and everything, it's important to come together, be a family, follow your dreams, be united as we are here today. And I am so proud of you for taking that step and fulfilling what you've been always wanting. And being always talking about your mom and your dad, always how proud of your son. And you're a great daughter as well. And like in Spanish, they say, prosperidad y mucho dinero.
Money.
Mucho dinero. Y'all heard it.
If anybody has a gray Hyundai, you need to come out and move your car. Gray Hyundai. Come out and move your car.
Excuse me.
Y'all love y'all.
I'm sorry.